Today's lesson is about bonus skills triggered by elemental unions. If a group union is vertical, you can say an elemental union is horizontal.
Unlike a group union, you can activate an elemental union with as few as 2 skills, so long as they're placed side by side.
Since there's 10 groups, does that mean you can put anywhere between 2 and 10 skills together?
Yeah. Depending on the number of skills you have lined up, the effects will change. You can even duplicate the same effects if you want.
So, like, if you have 2 each of the non-elemental skills, Attack and Rangus equipped,
you'll get 2 Elemental Union 2 bonus skills, reducing non-elemental damage by 20% instead of 10. Not only that, but you'll get 2 Stack 2 effects on top of that.
But you need to be careful. If you decide to equip just 1 of the 3rd non-elemental skill, Blued,
the bonus skill for Elemental Union 3 will activate, but the 2 Elemental Union 2 effects will both disappear.
So for Elemental Union bonus skills, it first checks the total length of the combo and then calculates how many of that combo to activate?
Yep, bonus skills are beneficial, but you have to really start thinking things through if you want to optimize your strengths.
It probably won't end well if you just use different equipment together blindly. So think carefully about what kind of equipment you want to use beforehand.
So, could you have an item where all 4 slots are the same skill in a 4 stack? Or an item that, just by itself, triggers an Elemental Union 4 bonus?
That's right. With proper item fusion and equipment coordination, you can draw out enormous power from skills. And there's one important announcement to be made.
Next week again, huh?
This is the last lesson.
What?
Really?
And that'll do it. We're becoming quite the family here.
Yeah, Rose and Dezel are actually pretty cool.
Well, I don't know about Rose, but if Dezel heard that, I'm quite sure he would object.
Yeah, I can imagine. Exploring these ruins like this gave me some perspective again. I gotten too worked up. Thank you, Miklio.
You helped yourself. Don't thank me.
Are you concerned about Dezel?
Well, kind of. If his aim is to kill Hellions, I want to stop him somehow.
If it does come to that, the Prime Lord has the authority to restrain a sublord if he decides to act up.
You can do that?
Yes, but ideally I'd rather not have to. Though there is a hierarchy between the Prime Lord and sublord, I'd rather we be friends. If Dezel travels along with you, Saray, I'm certain that he'll find some other reason for living besides revenge. He is a Seraph too, after all.
Let me tell you something.
What?
That girl, Rose, she conducts way too much power. I was able to enact the Armatus and control her body even when she was completely zonked out.
What do you mean?
She's far too used to the power of the Seraphim. It's probably because Dezel's been secretly interfering from the sidelines for so long. He must have manipulated her on multiple occasions while she was asleep or unconscious. If that weren't the case, there'd be no real explanation for why such power flows through her.
So Dezel used Rose to his own ends time and time again, just to get his revenge?
And just as he was hoping, Rose had the ability to enact the Armatus. If she loses consciousness, she can be manipulated freely. He's crafted the ideal vessel out of her. Keep that in mind.
Okay.
What?
No, well, I mean, not really. Just...
Just what?
I kinda like having you and Rose around.
What? What the hell are you getting at?
I mean, I used to think we were the only group of humans and Seraphim who traveled together.
It used to be quite a common affair. Even if people couldn't see us, couldn't hear our voices, they could feel us by their side. Together we laughed. Together we cried.
Weren't all of the scattered bones like that?
Exactly. And so that's why...
Hey.
Know this. We may be working together, but if you get in the way of what I need to do, there will be problems. Shepherd or no.
So you're finally awake.
Boy, howdy. You really helped me out there. My gratitude to the Shepherd, and of course my Seraph brethren.
I'm Saray. This is Lila, Edna, Dezel, Nicleo, and the one sleeping over there is...
That dog is talking!
Rose, you're awake.
Yep.
I am called Oish. Though I may not look it, I'm as much a Seraph as any of them.
I'm getting a crash course, Mystic Secrets of the Seraphim.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise, I'm Rose.
Looks like she's used to it.
So, shall we return now that Rose has recovered and awakened?
I don't know. She's having so much fun.
No screaming and punching? Lame.
We're wasting time. Let's head back.
Hold up! We haven't found anything yet, and there's more ruin left to explore.
Well, I guess there's only one thing to do.
Yep.
Keep going!
We're not done with our little expedition yet.
No vacation from this vacation.
Then let us proceed further in. Saray, are you ready?
Thanks, everyone. All right, Oish. We're going to look around in the ruins a bit more.
You folks are a blast, I tell you. Be careful out there.
See you later, Mystical Doggy.
I wonder how the war turned out.
Who knows? I remember the Roland's army falling apart.
Immediately afterwards, Highland also lost their general and retreated. I'd say it was a draw.
You were there too?
I like to watch.
I see.
So my actions directly affected the course of battle.
It's like what Lila said before.
Would Alicia and Lucas be all right?
Lucas would probably be okay. But as for Alicia... We'll just have to trust Highland.
I guess so.
In any case, we did what we needed to do.
That's right!
Come to think of it, you guys split up with Princess Alicia, right?
Yeah, in Marland.
Alicia has her own dreams to pursue, too.
So what? Does that make me a replacement?
What? No.
No!
Sorry to ask that way. Don't worry about it. I decided to join you guys of my own volition. But don't expect me to fit into that princess role.
We know that.
Glad you understand and all. But that's a little rude of you, don't you think?
That's a lot of dragons. Are these statues of the eight serpents?
No, it can't be. The numbers don't match. But it does look like relics of dragonism.
Taking the era into account, it might be logical to assume that the dragonist religion originates from that legend.
I can understand the whole deity worship thing, I guess. But why the dragons?
Beings of incomprehensible power. Symbols of awe-inspiring terror. Humans probably hoped that praise to such an entity would help them somehow.
Oh, shoot.
I've been all over, but I've never so much as seen a dragon's footprints. Oh, though I bet that thunder we heard at Rayfalk is enough to inspire dragon legends.
That's because that one was real.
Sure.
You can go there and verify for yourself. You would probably die, though.
What?
We met a dragon at Rayfalk.
It was, Edna's brother.
Wait, isn't Edna a seraph?
Yep. A dragon is what you get when a seraph accumulates too much malevolence.
It's okay. You don't have to apologize. I agree with you that praying to a dragon is a stupid idea.
Shall we go?
Stop that.
A werewolf? Probably some guildman. You returned Helion.
It specializes in assassin techniques. Watch out.
Earthborn!
The time that'll jump.
Right up, Tilly!
Rising sand!
Snacks? We're not built in a day, you know.
I can sense the ancient tongue. We're near one.
Ready, Nicleo?
What? If that huge snake bites you, it'll suck you dry.
Suck? Wait, what?
Fear my wings!
Now, let's spread out!
Well done! Finally protect
you! I can whip your own
sword!
Everyone okay?
go.
Lord of Wings! Wind
support!
Cut
Reaver!
Cut the protection!
Fearless Shock!
Not yet!
Wind of
Expander!
Fearless
Shock!
Surfing
current!
Snacks were not built in a day, you know.
Yeah.
What was that? It looked like a monster.
It's the Earth in Historia. It records events from the past.
Is this a record of wars throughout the world?
So that guy, Heldulf, he's using those wars as crucibles to breed more malevolence.
He pits Hellions against each other in order to increase their strength and ferocity.
Disgusting.
His heart is surely sunk in the depths of darkness.
That's the truth of the Lord of Calamity.
After me, Sorak!
There's...
Spellcasters turned Hellions who couldn't die peacefully. Don't underestimate their use of seraphic arts, fools.
You act on instinct way too much.
Oh? Did your instincts tell you that?
Time for battle!
Blaze of Fire! Look out!
Snacks were not built in a day, you know.
Ready, everyone?
Do not underestimate me.
Are we at the end?
Think so. I wonder if she'll ever really get used to this.
This mural seems to depict the trial that the one who is to be the shepherd must undertake. I did not expect to find such a thing here.
Whoa, the shepherd's trial, huh?
Is this blotch here supposed to represent the continent of Glenwood? Then this insignia thingy marks where the shepherd is supposed to go. Is that right?
Lila, is that the case?
Tonight's dinner, Mabo Curry!
Don't mind her. She gets a little random sometimes when things come up that she can't talk about because of her oath.
Oath? Like a diet?
So there are four places with that mark.
One in the north part of Lake Haven Heights, two in the southern end of the middle of the continent.
And the last one is in the direction of Western Bolt Gorge.
Well, if they call it a trial, that means something good happens if you finish it, right? Like maybe you get some awesome equipment or sweet power-ups.
Yeah. Hey, maybe I'll get the strength to overcome any kind of domain.
We just might have hope against Heldolf after all.
Guys, English please? What's a domain? What's a held elf?
Well, it's,
Know what? Forget it. We'll talk about it over a meal. We got what we came for, right?
Yeah. Looks like our expedition has come to an end.
Cool, let's go! I just got bored all the way back into my gourd. Didn't know you could do that.
For real?
Looks like it.
No comment.
What's that? A monolith written in ancient tongue.
Well, look who's back. Did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah. But...
Earth in Historia this, Shepherd Trial that. It's turning into one big mess.
I'm not sure where to start.
Well, think about it. The locations are all over the world. Plan it so we don't waste travel time.
All right. Then how's Pendrago sound? I'm sure you've grabbed the attention of the bigwigs in the Roland's Empire by now. You might want to go explain that Highland only got you to fight for them by force.
Oh, good idea. That would likely make our operations inside the Roland's Empire much easier.
An approach only the humans could take.
Looks like you're all on the same page.
That's right. Are you going to stay back here, Oish?
I'd sure like to. I'm still kind of attached to the place, but I probably don't dare stay here by myself.
Is something wrong?
There needs to be someone to worship the Seraph. Like at a shrine or a church.
Or else he could be tainted by malevolence and become a Hellion again.
Then we'll find someone and bring them here to cover it. Sound good?
You sure? I thought this was your hideout.
Whatever. Just leave it to me, okay?
You're the best. I should be sitting pretty for the time being, thanks to all you folks. Just bring someone here whenever you can. I'll give you blessings out the wazoo.
Well, I'll see you around, Oish.
Come back soon!
Thank you.
Anyway, we'll set out tomorrow.
What? I was thinking of heading out now.
With just the clothes on my back? Oh, please! I am a girl, you know.
Oh.
And...
Huh?
You have been battling those... Hellions, is that right? Those monsters most people can't see.
Yeah.
All the time?
Yeah. That man we were talking about, Heldolf, he's the Lord of Calamity, so...
Whoa, hold your horses. Save the long stories for mealtime, okay?
Let's go!
I'm on a journey with real-life Seraphim.
We're gonna be counting on you.
Gah! Pleasantries are fine and all, but disembodied voices give me the total willies!
I can't believe I'm on a journey with a real-life scaredy cat.
Pleasure to work with you too, Dezzel. Man, I sure am feeling the tension! Just like a real adventure!
Adventures in social psychology, maybe.
Why did these trees become hellions?
It's easy for souls to dwell in something that's lived for a long time.
Ready? Prepare yourself! Jade Luminescence! This is it! Run away!
Vermilion
Crescent! Run away!
You know, you're pretty mature, Rose.
Coming from you, I'm not sure how to take that.
What now, Edna?
And you're such a kid.
Make it quick!
Scumbag!
Already?
Yep, this is Lastonbell.
It's renowned the world over as a city where artisans and traders congregate.
That's the one! You know more about the world than I thought.
Line up and wait. Those who don't comply shall be punished.
You gotta be kidding. I don't have time for this.
An inspection?
It's the army. What do you think? There's gonna be a real war going on real soon. Odds are they'll be detaining you, I bet.
Huh? Why me?
You back there, pipe down!
Sorry!
You've heard the rumors about the Shepherd, right?
Yeah, in Highland, I think.
Right, but the latest word is he's made his way to Roland's.
Huh, no kidding. Crazy.
Does the Roland's Empire think unfavorably of the Shepherd?
You bet they do. The Knights have seen what he can do in battle and are all up in arms. And the Church has branded him a heretic. As if that wasn't enough, there's talk of mysterious happenings going on in town.
Next!
Oh, looks like I'm up. On that note, watch your back out there.
I thought we'd be fine, but now I'm not so sure.
I think it's best that you hide who you are, but the idea of making someone like you tell a lie is like...
It's like trying to convince your best hen to lay hard-boiled eggs.
Yeah.
Guess we better get ready to make a run for it.
We have a pass and everything. Just chill. I got this. Just no creepy head voices for the time being. Got it?
So long as you don't cause any trouble.
Okay.
Just keep your mouth shut.
Next!
I am Sergei Strelka, captain of the Platinum Knights, defenders of the glory of the Roland's Empire. In cooperating to ensure the Empire's peace, you prove your gratitude as much as your loyalty.
Is he always like this, or are his boxers just chafing him?
Here you go, our Merchant Guild pass. We've come to Lastonbell on business, specifically the collection of a bill.
The Sparrow Feathers are here. Quite impressive.
We've got a strict deadline, no time to waste. The place of business is the liquor establishment on the main road.
Ah, yes, Boris's canteen. That place certainly gets an awful lot of business.
And we deeply appreciate being a part of it. Is there anything else?
No. My gratitude for cooperating with our inspection.
Thanks for all your hard work.
Next, you there. Quite some garb you're wearing. Are you this young woman's guard?
A girl doesn't dare travel alone.
Then why does he carry an ornamental sword?
He knew that Saray's sword was ornamental? He's seeing right through us.
He's less of an idiot than he looks.
Wait, there are people watching. Well, you know, we have our reasons.
I'm asking your guard here.
Repeat after me.
Please forgive my unquestionably suspicious appearance. The truth is, I am the son of a provincial lord. Lord!
Hmm?
Rose.
That's right! My husband here is nobility.
What? You're married?
Never had I lifted anything heavier than a fork in my life. Yet by chance did I fall in love with a traveling merchant. In the throes of passion, I threw my money and land away to be with her just over a year ago.
You did?
Even my wife didn't know the full truth. The cruelties of the outside world taught me how feeble I truly am. But even so, I knew a husband has a duty to protect his wife. So I wear an ornamental sword at my side as a hollow pretense of strength. Laugh at the weak will of a sad, broken man. Ah! Sorry.
You're doing your best. It's cool.
Oh, my dearest, your sweet words are succor to my tired limbs.
Sow the seeds of love, and they will bloom no matter how arid the terrain. Live and be strong. Next!
I don't know how that worked, but I think we made it. Thanks, guys.
More like we just lucked into the perfect audience.
A win's a win.
Turns out it's handy to have an invisible woman on your side, isn't it?
I suppose. I'm sorry I told you to be quiet.
So it's all right if we communicate directly inside your...
No. It's creepy and obscene.
Obscene? I'm not obscene.
Come on. Let it go, Lila.
All right, then. I assume that we're on our way to Pendrago now?
Well,
But Mikleo, this town looks all kinds of exciting.
Well, it does, so...
We really ought to poke around at least a little. Did I nail it?
Guilty as charged.
Sounds fun. I'm game.
Bunch of children.
That's why we get along so well. And someday we all will.
You mean Seraphim and humans?
I remember this place was in the Celestial Record.
Get out of town! What do you mean they're selling elixir?
It's true. Word around town is that the nobles in Highland and Rollins can't get enough of the stuff.
But how are they getting access to it? I thought the church controlled the entire supply.
Well, they say they've got the church's blessing, no pun intended. And apparently the damn stuff actually works. Longer life, fresher breath, everything.
Well, don't that beat all?
What beats all is the price of that junk. You gotta be one rich chump, let me tell you.
Yeah, I should have guessed as much.
The church is selling elixir now?
Something sounds off about that.
Is this belfry all machine run?
Yep, it's what Lastonbell is famous for. The gears get moving, the bells get swinging, and it sounds like the most entrancing music.
Now that's something I'd like to hear.
Wow, you'll only get something like this in the City of Artisans. Such craftsmanship.
Oh, an art appreciator now, are you?
I wonder how the motor works.
Don't ask me.
I hear the sound of the drawworks. They're probably utilizing the power of the aqueduct running underground.
Aqueduct?
Really? Nothing I can see suggests that.
That's because it's a hidden refuge area. This place was built as a fort in the first place.
Oh, so that's why this place is surrounded by castle walls.
Before it was a fancy belfry, this was a communication tower for sending smoke signals.
So much history everywhere. This is too cool.
Guys seriously geek out over the weirdest things.
Well, let them have their fun.
Yeah, I suppose.